5 seconds. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed a great pleasure for me to be a part of the Golden Jubilee celebrations of your Agricultural University. Today marks 50 years of glorious journey of this great institution. You are aware that this was the only agricultural university for the region until the year 2000. When the Central Agricultural University was established for the first time, even with that university in place now, Agricultural University still continues to welcome students not only from the region but also from the country and all over the world. I am delighted at the rapid progress being made by this university, making it one of the top institutions of India. As a step in the right direction, this university has opened its doors to the farming community, and it is working hand in hand with the farmers, supporting them in their efforts to augment productivity and profitability. I congratulate each one of you for your contribution to the growth of agricultural sector. However, we have a long and journey ahead to be undertaken in collaboration with all stakeholders. There are challenges that we need to address in our country. You must build on your past achievements and address these new challenges and tap new opportunities. One of our challenges is to achieve self-sufficiency in the pulses and oilseed sector. I am sure that with the dedication demonstrated by our farmers and the research being conducted in our laboratories, we will achieve self-sufficiency in the years to come. I am fully aware that for our food security, we need to respond effectively to the changing needs of our farm sector. These needs are emerging out of the contemporary realities like climate change and diminishing water resources. Due to the prevailing factors, the farming profession is becoming uneconomical and unattractive day by day. In order to meet these challenges effectively, we need highly skilled and motivated human resources. Over the years, the agriculture sector in the state is marching ahead steadily. At present, it is growing at around 5%. While the state is self-sufficient in rice, special efforts are needed for increasing the production of oil seeds and pulses. I understand that wheat is not a popular crop with farmers of the state. I am very happy to say that a great scope exists in the wheat sector. The university, state government and the farmers have to work together to realize the potential. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to increase not only production but also encourage farms to diversify and take up allied activities like poultry, dairy and fisheries to supplement their incomes. I hope and trust that there will be big demand for dairy and meat products in your state as well as the entire region. It is therefore necessary to turn this challenge into an opportunity. In this connection, I am very happy to note that the state government led by your Honorable Chief Minister has planned to focus its attention on animal husbandry and revitalize it. In my view, this is the need of the hour. Farmers should be encouraged to diversify and take up allied activities at all costs and overcome uncertain returns from farming. As a matter of fact, the farmers should be given the encouragement and provide technical and to grow horticulture crops and floriculture in your state. I know that some significant progress has already been made in this direction. As your state is rich in natural resources and you should put them to optimum use so as to generate wealth. In addition, the farmers should be empowered with knowledge, financial credit, warehousing and insurance facilities. They need to be provided the know-how and do-how to improve the farm productivity. That is what the universities are expected to provide. We need to ensure that they do so even more efficiently in the years to come. We need to rethink and revitalize agricultural education and research. My dear friends, knowledge makes all the difference. Therefore, the educational institutions must generate new ideas, extend the frontiers of science, knowledge and search for practical solutions to the challenging problems. You must equip farmers with these knowledge, insights and products. You must interact with farmers, discover new products and practices and disseminate new insights and knowledge. We must also simultaneously examine and rediscover promising practices that the farmers are already adopting on their farms. India has a great heritage of agricultural science and has the leader of path-breaking discoveries over the continue the scientific tradition. Young agricultural scientists will have to be encouraged to research and innovate. The universities must nurture young talent and provide adequate opportunities for learning from the field, and the ability to communicate research findings to the farming community must be made an integral part of our education. You are aware that our Mother Earth is a treasure house, a truly remarkable source of our sustenance. It is therefore necessary that we must have the knowledge and wisdom to use this treasure for our livelihood and well-being. We must protect and preserve and renew our natural resources, agricultural universities like yours have an important role to play in making farming attractive, innovative and sustainable. You have been doing wonderful work in the last few years. I wish you many more successful years in the service of the farming community.